Welcome to lecture number 5, Velocity and Acceleration Analysis of Mechanisms using Analytical Method. In the previous lectures, we got introduction into what is analytical or complex algebra method, derivation of velocity and acceleration for slider crank and four bar mechanisms, and solving a simple numerical on slider crank mechanism. So in this lecture, we will attempt to solve a problem on four bar mechanism using the complex algebra method. So we'll look into the problem statement. So figure shows a four bar mechanism. So we have a four bar mechanism that is given here. So they have defined the length of link AB. So I will call this as link number one. Let me call this as a link two. Let me call this as a link three, and let me call it as link number four. So they have defined length of link AB, that is R2 is defined as 200 millimeter. CD, they have defined the length of link of length of link four, R4. DA, and they have defined the length of link R1. So they have defined that AB rotates at a uniform speed of 90 radian per second. AB is 2, so therefore they have defined what is theta 2 single dot. The value of theta 2 single dot is defined in the problem, so that is nothing but omega 2. Also, looking into the diagram, 120 degree is given as theta 2, that is the angular position of 2 with respect to horizontal, and 90 degree is given, that is theta 4, angular position of 4 with respect to the horizontal. These are the data given. So looking into the problem, nothing is mentioned about theta 2 double dot, angular acceleration of link 2. The basic principle is that out of all the given links, I should know all the parameters, angular position, angular velocity, and angular acceleration for at least one link. So I know theta 2, I know theta 2 single dot, and I don't know the value of theta 2 double dot, and it is not defined in the problem also. So in that case, assume that value as 0. So what are the things that I am supposed to find out? They have not mentioned anything about length of the link R3. They have not mentioned anything about the angular position of link 3, that is theta 3. Also, angular velocity of link 3, theta 3 single dot, angular velocity of link 4, theta 4 double dot, angular acceleration of link 3, theta 3 double dot, angular acceleration of link 4, theta 4 double dot. So those are the 6 unknowns that I am supposed to find out. So since theta 2 double dot or alpha 2 is not defined, consider that as equal to 0. So this is a simple four bar mechanism that we have considered. So let me choose point A to write the vectors. So right side, I am going to draw a horizontal line, right? So that becomes the reference line for defining the angles for theta 1. So since I am drawing, so that will be the direction of the vector R1 for link 1. This will be the direction. To define the angle for 2, I am going to define with respect to the same reference in the counterclockwise direction. And in the same direction, we will have the vector R2 for link 2. Similarly, with respect to point B, I am going to draw a right side horizontal line, measure the angle in the counterclockwise direction. So in the same direction, we will have the vector for link 3, that is R3. So instead of point C, I have chosen point D. To the right side, I have drawn a horizontal line and I have defined the angle in the counterclockwise direction. So in the same direction, I will have the direction of R4, that is vector for link number 4. So by observation, we can conclude that R2 and R3 are in a similar direction, and R4 and R1 are in direction opposite to that of R2 and R3. So the loop closure equation would be R2 plus R3 minus R1 minus R4 equal to 0. So for the sake of convenience, I have defined all the parameters that are involved in the problem. So R1, R2 and R3 are nothing but length of link 1, 2, 3 and 4. Theta 2, theta 3, theta 4 indicates angular position of links. Omega 2, omega 3, omega 4 indicates angular velocities. Alpha 2, alpha 3, alpha 4 indicates the angular accelerations. So going forward, these are the values that are given. They have defined R2, R4, R1, theta 2 single dot, angular velocity of link 2, angular position of link 2, angular position of 4, angular position of 1. So they have not given anything about angular acceleration of 2, but I have assumed that to be equal to 0. So these are the values that I am supposed to find out. What is the length of link 3, angular position of link 3, angular velocity of link 3 and 4, angular acceleration of link 3 and 4. So these are the 6 unknowns that I am supposed to find out. So for that, consider the loop closure equation. So each term indicates a vector for each link. R2 is a vector for 2, so R3 is vector for 3, R1, R4, etc. So each one can be represented with respect to both magnitude as well as the direction. So capital R2 has magnitude of small r2 and angular position theta 2, so similarly defined for R3, R1 and R4. So for time being, do not substitute theta 1 is equal to 0 and replace it and eliminate j theta 1. Don't do that. So we will eliminate that after differentiation. So we will apply the Euler's equation, and wherever there is e to the power of j theta, we will substitute cos theta plus j sin theta including theta 1. Right. So now separate the real and imaginary parts. R2 cos theta 2, R3 cos theta 3, R1 cos theta 1, R4 cos theta 4. They become the real part. Whatever that coefficient of J, R2 J sin theta 2. So they become the imaginary part. So we have equation 2, that is the real part. Equation 3, that is the imaginary part. So I will consider the equation number 2. So substitute all the values that are known to me. So R2 cos theta 2 is known to me, R1 cos theta 1 is known to me, R4 cos theta 4 is known to me. So I substitute, but I don't know anything about R3 cos theta 3. So except that everything is known. So the equation would be in terms of R3 and cos theta 3 as 4. So write the equation 4 and keep it as it is, so that we can deal with equation number 4 later. So similarly, consider equation number 3, the imaginary part. So here we know R2 sin theta 2, those values are given. R1 sin theta 1 values are given. R4 sin theta 4 values are given. I don't know anything about R3 sin theta 3. So substitute the values that are known to you and simplify, so that the final equation would be in terms of R3 sin theta 3. Call that as equation number 5. So already I have equation number 4, R3 cos theta 3. I have equation number 5, R3 sin theta 3. So R3 is nothing but length of link 3. Theta 3 is nothing but angular position of 3. I have to solve for both. So there are simultaneously two unknowns. So equation, if I divide equation 5 by equation 4, R3, R3 gets cancelled. I get tan theta 3 equal to some number, and I can solve for theta 3. So the moment I solve for theta 3, if I come back to either 4 or 5 and substitute, I get the value for R3. So in the next step, I will divide equation 5 by 4 so that R3 gets eliminated and I get the value for theta 3. The same value of theta 3, I am going to substitute it in equation 4. Wherever there is theta 3, replace it by 35.43. I get the value of length of link 3, that is R3, as 0.737 meters. So I am successful in finding two unknowns, right? By substituting or by applying Euler's equation directly to the loop closure equation, right? So we can solve for theta 3 as well as R3. So now I take the same loop closure equation and differentiate that with respect to time once, so that I can solve for angular velocities now, right? So the variables here are theta 2, theta 3, theta 1 and theta 4. So e to the differential of e to the power of j theta 2 is j theta 2 single dot e to the power of j theta 2. So repeat the same procedure for R3, R1 as well as R4. So I have theta 1 dot. Since theta 1 is 0, rate of change of that, so since link 1 is fixed, it will not have any angular velocities. This entire term becomes equal to 0. So we have simply only R2, R3 and R4 terms. So now apply the Euler's formula for the equation number 6. So wherever there is e to the power of j theta, replace it by cos theta plus j sin theta. So you can expand that R2 theta 2 single dot j into cos theta 2, j into j, it becomes minus 1. So similarly repeat for R3 as well as R4. So now I am going with respect to equation 7, or for the equation 7, or from the equation 7, we are going to separate the real and imaginary parts. So here the real part is R2 theta 2 single dot into minus sin theta 2. So that will be the real part. R2 theta 2 single dot cos theta 2. So that would be the imaginary part, which has coefficient of j. So I have separated the real part and imaginary part from the previous equation number 7 now. So consider any one. So I will consider equation number 8. So in this equation, what are the things that are known to me? What are the things that are not known to me? So if I go through the entire expression, R theta 3 single dot and theta 4 single dot, these are the two values that I do not know. Apart from that, all other values are given in the problem, or I have found out in the previous steps. So substitute everything. So the final equation should be in terms of theta 3 single dot and theta 4 single dot. Let us call it as equation number 10, which we will take or consider at a later stage. So now I have equation number 9. So let me take up equation number 9. So I know everything here except theta 3 single dot and theta 4 single dot. So these are the variables, and substitute for all the remaining values. So when I substitute that, I can substitute for cos theta 4. Theta 4 is 90. Cos 90 is 0. So this entire term on the right hand side becomes equal to 0. So when it becomes 0, it also takes away one of the unknowns with it. So theta 4 single dot gets eliminated. So the only unknown that remains in the equation will be theta 3 single dot. So solve for theta 3 single dot, that is angular velocity of link 3, omega 3, as 15 radian per second. So the moment I know the value of theta 3 single dot, go back to equation number 10 in the previous slide. So substitute here, substitute for theta 3 single dot as 15 radian per second. So I can get the value of what is theta 4 single dot. So substituting here, theta 3 single dot as 15 radian per second, we know what is the value of theta 4 single dot, which is angular velocity of link 4, that is omega 4. So in case in the exam, if they ask you to find only angular velocities of the links, you are going to come up to this slide and stop the problem, right? You don't have to continue for acceleration. In case they ask you to find out the angular acceleration of the links, so then continue. So for that, I am going to assume angular acceleration of crank as 0. So this is the equation that was remaining for the finding of angular velocities. So let me, before differentiation, let me consider the variables. Theta 2 dot is a variable, theta 2 is a variable, theta 3 single dot, theta 3, theta 1 dot, theta 1, theta 4 single dot, theta 4. So these are the variables. So if you observe carefully, in a single term, I have two variables. So I have to apply the chain rule of differentiation. One term, so theta 2 single dot has to be differentiated, e to the power of j theta 2 will be kept as constant. In the next term, e to the power of j theta 2 will be differentiated, j theta 2 single dot will be kept as constant. So we will observe for one so that we can repeat the same for others. So differential of j theta 2 single dot is j theta 2 double dot, e to the power of j theta 2 kept as it is. Differentiation of e to the power of j theta 2 is j theta 2 single dot into e to the power of j theta 2 plus j theta 2 single dot is already present. So it becomes square of it, right? So similarly, repeat the same procedure for R3 as well as R4. So both will get two terms. So R1, so since it has theta 1 dot, so it gets equated to 0. So consider that term. So wherever there is e to the power of j theta 2, replace it by cos theta plus j sin theta and simplify it. So observe it carefully. I have j theta 2 single dot square. So it is something like j square into theta 2 single dot square. So this j square is nothing but minus 1. So j square is minus 1. So that minus 1 is taken in the form of minus here. R2 theta 2 single dot cos theta 2 plus j sin theta 2. So here when I come here, R3. So theta 3 double dot is written here. So j into cos theta, j cos theta 3, j into j sin theta 3. So j into j will be j square, which is minus 1. That is the reason why it has become negative here. J term disappears and you get sin theta 3. So similarly, R3 into theta 3 single dot square, that is the term that I have got. J, so here you can observe carefully, j into theta 3 single dot square. So this also becomes j square. So the coefficient becomes negative. So similarly, repeat the same procedure for R4. Be careful in the expansion process. So consider the same thing and segregate or separate the real and imaginary parts out of that equation. So real part will be equation number 11 and imaginary part will be equation number 12. So to continue, let me consider equation number 11. So in the equation number 11, I have only two unknowns here, theta 3 double dot and theta 4 double dot. These are the two variables. Apart from these two, all other values are known to me from the given problem statement. So substitute all other values and simplify so that the final expression should be in terms of theta 3 double dot and theta 4 double dot. Call that as equation number 13, which can be dealt at a later stage. So now consider equation number 12. So here substitute all the values that are known to you. So here also theta 3 double dot is not known to me and theta 4 double dot is not known to me. So again, you can note that I know the value of theta 4, 90 degree. and the coefficient of theta 4 double dot is cos theta 4, and cos 90 is 0. So this entire term becomes equal to 0, and when it is becoming 0, it is also taking away one of the unknowns. So the only one unknown that remains in the equation will be theta 3 double dot. So apart from that, all other values will be known to me. So upon substitution and simplification, we get the value for theta 3 double dot as 1153.06 radian per second, which is nothing but angular acceleration of link 3. So now, once I know the value of theta 3 double dot, I can go back to the previous equation 13. So if I substitute theta 3 double dot here, I can find out what is the value of theta 4 double dot, as simple as that. So again, consider equation number 13 and substitute the value for theta 3 double dot, which is found as 1153.06. So you get the solution for theta 4 double dot, that is alpha 4, as angular acceleration of link 4. You get minus 304 radian per second square. Negative sign indicates that the direction of angular acceleration will be opposite to that of the assumed direction. In the vectorial representation, whatever the direction that we are represented, it will be opposite to that. So that is the meaning of negative sign. So we have found out angular acceleration for link 4 as well as angular acceleration for link 3. So to summarize, so these were the values that were given to us. So they had given R1, R2, R4. So we found out R3. So they had given everything about 2. They had given theta 2, omega 2, and we assumed alpha 2 as 0. Apart from that, they had given theta 4 as well as theta 1. By applying the complex algebra procedure, we found the length of link 3, angular position of 3, angular velocity of link 3, angular acceleration of 3, angular velocity of link 4, and angular acceleration of link 4. So to summarize, this is what we did in the problem. So this ends lecture number 5. And in the subsequent module 3 part 2, we will deal with kinematic synthesis, the Frankenstein equations, and the function generation. Right? So thank you.